deploy, and configure Unity VSA. Anytime we look to do a deployment of any type of software or virtual platform, you want to make sure you review the prerequisites. The reason that they release prerequisites is to allow you to build up an environment that's going to be suitable to support your particular requirements. The prerequisites in the case of a Unity VSA are fairly specific, and they should be adhered to as a minimum. Keep in mind, with something like a storage appliance, you have to meet those minimums, otherwise you really will not have a good experience, whether you're doing this for test, dev, production, or whatever the case may be. You really need to make sure that those prerequisites are met and be consistent about the deployment of those prerequisites if you're doing multiples in order to make sure you have successful deployments. The first thing we need to look at is if you're doing a vCenter deployment, you need to have vCenter 5.5 update 2 or higher in order to make sure that the Unity VSA works properly. The reason we need a 5.5 update 2 or higher is the base virtual machine that is delivered as part of the Unity VSA requires that we have that or higher in order to function properly. So make sure you review your vCenter implementation prior to deploying the OVA or OVF. Next, we need ESXi 5.x or 6.x. As we move forward from this course publish date, you may need to review the prerequisites of the deployment in order to make sure that you're meeting the minimums that are being specified for the current version of the Unity VSA. 6.x is a pretty common platform to be deployed to and works really, really well. So if you have the opportunity in your environment, make sure you get to the newest release of 6 and deploy your Unity VSA on that platform. Next, you need a web browser with the latest version of Firefox, Chrome, Internet Explorer, Safari, Edge. As long as you're utilizing a modern browser that supports HTML5, you should be fine. You are able to do deployments utilizing a tablet or an Android device, but I would highly recommend that you use a full-size computer or a full-size tablet laptop in order to do the deployment. It just makes life a little bit easier, and you're able to function as expected, and you won't run into any kind of menu issues or things like that when you're trying to do the deployment.